Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today let's continue with our previous series of fascinating vertebral appearances. Cupped vertebra or H vertebra is a result of central depression in the end plate that occurs with an abrupt transition to the more normal periphery, usually seen with sickle cell anemia disease, but sometime can also be seen with Gaucher's, hereditary spherocytosis and diseases like thalassemia. Double spinous process sign is seen with Clay-Shoveless avulsion fracture owing to the caudal displacement of the avulsed fragment. Empty vertebra sign is seen in chance fracture, also called as seatbelt injury. The horizontal fracture through both pedicle and transverse process produce a horizontal loosened defect that is projected over the body of the involved vertebra. Fish vertebra, fish mouth vertebra, codfish vertebra, fish bone vertebra, hourglass vertebra or hourglass deformity are various names given to this appearance. This is actually due to upward and downward bulging of the intervertebral disc. This simulates the vertebral shape found in the fish or sometimes the bulges seen in the fish mouth. Such deformity or such appearances is classical for osteoporosis but can also be seen in diseases like sickle cell anemia, hyperparathyroidism, rickets, neurofibromatosis and condition like Hanschler-Christian diseases too. Flame-shaped vertebra are usually seen with diseases like Marquio syndrome, which is nothing but a mucopolysaccharidosis type 4. Here in this disease, the superior and inferior vertebral end plates taper to form a central beak, giving this characteristic flame-shaped appearance. Ghost vertebra is actually a finding after an intravenous thorotrast administration. This is actually due to radio-opaque densities of infantile vertebra within the adult vertebral body. Gooseneck deformity, or also called as swan neck deformity, is seen after extensive laminectomy for diseases like neurofibromatosis. Thus, it is a post-operative finding. This is in turn caused by dislocation or subluxation of cervical vertebra and usually seen on lateral view. It is usually associated also with progressive thoracic kyphosis and compensatory cervical hyperlordosis. Heaping up vertebra, also called as pear-shaped vertebra, is seen in spondyloepiphyseal dysplasia tarda. This happens as a result of accumulation of bone at the posterior aspect of superior and inferior vertebral end plates. Hourglass vertebra is seen with senile osteoporosis. This happens because of the end plates which are getting compressed by upward and downward protrusion of intervertebral disc material. This happens more in the mid portion of the body when compared to the periphery, so giving rise to this hourglass appearance. Intravertebral vacuum cleft sign is usually following a steroid-induced ischemic vertebral collapse. This appearance is due to the gaseous cleft within a transverse separation of the vertebral body in a patient with vertebral collapse. This is best seen in extension and may disappear in flexion. Ivory vertebra is due to an uniformly radio-opaque vertebral body seen with diseases like Paget's disease, osteoblastic metastasis, osteopetrosis. Also can be seen with diseases like fluorosis, lymphoma and myelosclerosis. Thanks a lot for listening. If you like our content, please do support us by subscribing this channel. Thank you.